In my last video, I made this really cool hatchet that's made of steel and aluminum bronze. I love the way it turned out, but as I was making it, I really couldn't help but wonder how strong a solid aluminum bronze hatchet would be. So in today's video, that's what I'll be making, and I'll also test it out on a few different species of wood to see how well it works and to see if it can hold an edge. I'll be sandcasting this hatchet just like I did the last one. I'm using the same basic design, but I did alter the 3D printed pattern slightly. Before I can make a sand mold, I need to make a core for the eye of the hatchet. I'm mixing sand and sodium silicate together, which will harden in the presence of CO2 and hold its shape. I haven't made a video about building it, but I really love this workbench slash molding bench that I made recently. Sandcasting is messy, and this bench makes it much more enjoyable to work with. I made a mistake when making this pattern, and I glued the locating pins into the wrong side. It's not a big deal though, I just have to start on the top of the mold instead of starting on the bottom. The mold will be pretty simple. I have to do a fair amount of grinding on the finished casting, so it really doesn't have to be perfect. If you're wondering, aluminum bronze is a really strong alloy of copper and aluminum. I use about 90% copper and 10% aluminum by weight to make it. One of the challenges with aluminum bronze is that it shrinks a lot when it's cast. These big holes are called risers. They'll fill up with metal and act as reservoirs to supply the casting with liquid metal as it solidifies and shrinks. I have some bronze left over from my last casting, but not quite enough, so I'll add in some more copper and aluminum. You can see what I meant about the metal shrinking. Watch how it gets pulled down into the casting. If I hadn't added these risers, then the casting itself would have large voids in it. I think it actually looks pretty cool like this. I was thinking about leaving it, but I decided against it. Maybe I'll do something like this in the future. There is a pretty noticeable imperfection in the casting that I can't grind out, so I'll fill it with a little bit of weld. The filler rod that I'm using was part of my last casting, so it's the same exact alloy, and once I grind off the excess, it'll blend in perfectly. Aluminum bronze can actually be work hardened to make it quite a bit stronger, and that's what I'm going to do. This will make it much more effective and allow it to hold an edge for longer. I can feel the metal work hardening as I'm striking it. The first blow is fairly soft, but as I keep hitting the same spot, I can feel it getting harder and harder, and the hammer starts to bounce off of it. Well, that went well, and I didn't make too big of a mess of it, so now I just have to grind it smooth and put a sharp edge on it. I decided to put a small chamfer on the edges, and I'm really glad I did. I think it made it look a lot nicer. What do you think? Now I'll start working on the handle. I have this piece of hard maple, which should work. I read that it's not the best choice because although it is hard enough, it does a poor job at absorbing vibrations. For a handle this small though, I really don't think it'll be a problem. Before I can attach a handle, I need to widen the top of the eye so that when I pound in a wedge, the wood will expand into it, locking it in place. Off camera, I used some walnut to make a wedge, and I also made a couple small steel wedges. I thought walnut would look really nice up against a lighter maple. The last step is to seal the wood with some boiled linseed oil, and it's done. Okay, let's test this thing out. A couple of weeks ago, some crazy wind gusts came through and knocked over a bunch of trees, including this one. That's not much of a surprise though, since it looks like I could have just pushed this over myself. Let's see how well this hatchet can cut through it. Well, that went really well, and other than some sap, I really can't tell this thing was used at all. Next up, I'll try some dry pine, some hard maple, which, now that I think about it, is a bit like cannibalism since the hatchet handle is made of maple, and I'll finish up with some white oak. Well, it's definitely a bit dull after that pine. I'm really surprised because I thought it was going to hold up a little better. Alright, let's cut up that piece of maple. Well, look at that, the edge folded over. I guess this is just a little bit too hard for this alloy. The oak will be just as hard, if not harder, than the maple, so there's really no point in testing it. I'll just end up destroying the hatchet. I think this was a worthwhile project, and the hatchet isn't ruined. I'll just grind a new edge onto it. I'm sure there are other aluminum bronze alloys out there that would hold up better than this one did, and maybe a broader edge would work better also. Either way, I really enjoyed making this and testing it out. If you would like to make one of these things for yourself, I'll have the 3D printing files available on my Patreon. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please let me know what you think in the comments. Give the video a thumbs up and subscribe for future projects. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.